Today I will review one very solid product with industrial quality that have LAN Ethernet, Wi-Fi and NFC and can be used to control devices locally using 7 different protocols or from the cloud. The device is called PowerDIN 4PZ and it comes from a vendor called Netio located in Europe. I will show you what this device is capable of and how integrated with Home Assistant. What's up, KPeyanski is here. Do you know what is zero current switching? Or S0 pulse counting? Me neither, until very recently, but now I have this device which support this stuff and I already know about them. Don't worry, I'm going to explain them to you while I'm showing you the other features of PowerDIN 4PZ and I'll demonstrate Home Assistant integration, starting right now. Let's first see what we have in the box and then we are going to continue further with the setup of PowerDIN 4PZ and its features review. Quick installation guide in English and in Czech. And the Netio PowerDIN 4PZ itself. It has 2 power inputs with max 16 amps or 3600 watts. Input 1 and input 2 are dry contacts. And they support S0 counting. S0 counting is an industry standard pulse output of water meter, electricity meters, gas meters and so on. That means this device will remember the state of the S0 counter even after power outage. We also have 4 outputs here. Output 1, output 2, output 3 and 4. Output 1 and 2 supports max voltage of 230 volts, 16 amps AC in total and they can display variety of measurements. These measured values can be displayed via any of the supported machine-to-machine open protocols. They also support zero current switching. Zero current switching significantly extends the lifetime of the connected equipment, especially in case of frequent on-off switching of devices that are not designed for that. And I'm talking about devices such as servers, computers, LED lights, electric motors and other IT equipment. Output 3 and 4 doesn't support any measurements. They're using relay switching with normally closed and normally open. They don't support zero current switching as well. Their max voltage is 230 volts, 2 amps AC and 48 volts, 2 amps DC. We also have one Ethernet cable port. The device is designed to fit on DIN rail. We have several LEDs here for outputs, inputs, machine-to-machine and Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi is working when the LAN cable is not plugged in, so you can use either the LAN or the Wi-Fi. And we have a reset button that should be right here. I'll quickly try to open this plate. Here it is. This is the default button that you can use to reset the device if there is such need. I'll put this back on and we can continue further.
Let's connect this industrial bad boy to the power grid so we can set it up and access its interfaces.
I connected the line here. The neutral is here, exactly as shown on this picture right here. And also I connected this downlight. One of the wire goes to the output 2, and the other wire is going to one of the three neutral slots right here. So I think I'm ready, and now I'll connect this device to the power grid and we will see what will happen. The inputs, outputs, machine to machine and Wi-Fi blinked and then they stopped. Okay, the Netio PowerDIN 4PS was not in AP pairing mode for some reason, and the Wi-Fi LED was blinking slowly. It has to blink fast. I could easily pair the device using the LAN cable here, or I could use the Discovery utility that they have for Windows and macOS, but I decided to use the Wi-Fi mode. And I'm glad that I did that, because I found out that they're using the ESP32 chip. I'm not sure this is visible on the camera, but this is the chip. And now I will demonstrate you how to factory reset the device. According to the instruction, you have to push this default button and power the device and hold this button for at least 10 seconds. So let's do that. I'll push the button now and I'll connect the device to the power grid. Okay, I'll release that. Now the LED is blinking quickly, very good. I think I'm ready to continue on my computer now.
The device is connected and ready to be used. Let's see what options do we have in the web interface.
Let's see what we have here in the Wi-Fi networks. Here it is, PowerDIN AP. Now it asks me where to connect the device. I want to connect it here, and I'll hit next. Now I have to type the password. I can name the device here. I can select or deselect the DHCP, but I'll leave it like that. Hope that I guess my password. Yes, the password is correct. This is my new IP address. I'll save and connect again, and then I'll click this link, which will open the interface of the Netio PowerDIN 4PS. Oh, I have to connect to my usual Wi-Fi now, and then to open this IP address. I guess I have to type it manually. 3205. And here it is. The default username is admin. The password is also admin. Sign in. I will not remember the password because I will change it later. And this is it. The PowerDIN 4PS web interface. Let's try to power the output 2 now to see if everything is okay. Yes, it is working. Pretty nice. You can also see the load is 7 to 8 watts, the current, the voltage, everything is working. I'll turn off this for now. And let's examine the PowerDIN web interface for all of the options. Click to open settings. Let's see what we have here. We can name the output. We can change the milliseconds for short on-off delay. We can change the power-up state. That means if there is power outage and after that the power is restored, in what state the device should be. In on state, in off state, or it can remember the last state. and you can set here the power up interval in milliseconds. So let's try to change this to down light, for example, save changes. And my output is now down light. Let's see inputs. Oh, we have some values in the counter already. Let's continue. Machine-to-machine API protocols. This is getting interesting. You can enable and use any of these protocols to connect to the Netio PowerDIN 4PS device. MQTT Flex, which is a variant of standard MQTT developed by Netio. And I'm planning to use some of these protocols later to connect to my home assistant, but we'll see that in a minute. Cloud section, you can enable Netio Cloud from here, currently is off. You have to create a registration token on this address and to add it here and to save changes. And you can control this device from the cloud, from anywhere, using the mobile app or the Netio Cloud web interface. From here, you can create a new users, or you can change the admin password, which you should mandatory do. I'll do it as well on later stage. And we have settings here, the Wi-Fi, the network and signal, network configuration, Wi-Fi and Ethernet. Date and time, you can use the NTP servers. From here you can install firmwares. If there are new, just choose the new firmware and install it. And system, uptime, firmware version, device name. You can change the HTTP port if you wish. That's nice. You can enable periodic device restarts in minutes. You can enable debug lock. You can locate the device. So when I click on the locate button, the status LEDs will blink for 1 minute. And this is also nice. You can export the configuration and import it on another device. And we have lock, where all of the events are stored, and you can export them to file if you wish.
Okay, we can control the Netio PowerDIN 4PS from its web interface. Let's try to connect and control it from Home Assistant.
I'll go to machine-to-machine API protocols in the Netio PowerDIN 4PS. And these are the protocols that I can use, but I want to enable this one, JSON API. I'll tick this. I'll also enable read and write access to this protocol, because I want not only the status of the PowerDIN, but to change the status as well. And I'll hit save. This is the URL where all of the statuses are stored. As you can see here, the device name and the outputs, the name of the output, the current state, and so on. Everything is here in this JSON, and I'm going to use it in Home Assistant. I'll open my file editor and I'll paste some YAML code inside, and I'll explain what exactly this YAML is doing. It will create a sensor inside Home Assistant. This sensor will use platform REST, and the resource is exactly the same as this URL here. Probably you want to change this to your Netio device. The name is optional, you can type whatever you wish here. I want to monitor the output 2 of the device, because I connected my downlight there. And this sensor will have these attributes, and these attributes can be found using this attributes path parameter. ID1 of outputs. equals this exact row, which is power output 2. If I want to monitor output 1, I have to change this to 0, because the IDs are starting from 0 here, but I want power output 2, and the actual value of this sensor along with these attributes will be the state. I can change it to whatever I wish, but I want to the state, and again the ID of the output is 1, which is actually the power output 2, and I'll have this username and password to authenticate. You can change these parameters from here. They are the default one. It is a good idea to change them. And I'll save these changes. Then I'll go to configuration. I'll open it on another tab. Server control, check config, and restart Home Assistant. After Home Assistant is restarted, I can hit the E key. This is from the latest Home Assistant version. And I can search for my new sensor name here, which is PowerDIN 4PS. And as you can see, everything is working very good. This is the current state. 0 means the power output 2 is disabled. And down below are all of the attributes. If I enable the output 2, this parameter should be changed. It takes several seconds to refresh, but here it is, they are working. Now the state is 1, that means it's on. The output 2 is on. And these are all of the measurements that PowerDIN have. I'll close this. And I'll turn this off.
We can check the status of Netio PowerDIN 4PS from Home Assistant. Let's try to control the outputs now.
And we are going to continue further. I want to toggle this switch from the Home Assistant. To do that, I'll paste another YAML code below this one. You can get both of these sensor and command from the video description. This YAML code will create one REST command with that name, toggle output 2, and it will use post method for this URL, the same URL that Netio PowerDIN 4PS exposed, and this will be the payload that will send using the post method, and again the username and the password. I'll hit save, then I'll go again to server controls, check config, and I'll restart again my Home Assistant. After Home Assistant is restarted, I'll quickly check if there is such service in developer tools. Yes, here it is, REST command toggle output. And if I call the service, everything is working. I can turn on and off my downlight. I can now add all of these things on my Home Assistant dashboard. I'll quickly create one script here. Toggle output 2. The icon can be anything. For example, like this. The action will be call service. And the service will be toggle this one, the command, the REST command that I created earlier. And I'll hit save. Now I can quickly execute this script, which will toggle the power output 2. And I can add it now to my dashboard. I'll choose the button card, and for the entity I'll choose toggle output 2, and I have a big button now that I can control from it the PowerDIN 4PS. I can also add the sensor that I created before. Where it is? Here it is, sensor PowerDIN 4PS output 2. This is the current state, 0. If I click on it, I can get all of the attributes. And I think everything is great with this Netio PowerDIN 4PS and Home Assistant integration.
Any sort of engagement on this channel does really help a lot with the YouTube algorithm. So you make sure that you hit the subscribe, like and bell buttons if you enjoyed this video. Also, feel free to add me on Twitter by searching for this username. I'm trying to post there frequently. You can also find me on my Discord server as well. And if you want to secure this channel existence, you can become one of my supporters. You can see exactly how in the video description below. I really hope that you find this information useful and you now know more about Netio PowerDIN 4PS, zero current switching, S0 counting and Home Assistant REST interface. Stay safe and don't forget, home smart but not hard. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.